Tonight, for the first time, we're hearing about Chris Barton's reaction to the news that police had recovered what they believe are the remains of his son, Lonzie Barton.
According to his attorney, Barton found out while watching News 4 Jax from the Baker County Jail, where he's being held on charges of drug dealing. Also tonight, members of the community are doing what they can to remember this toddler as the innocent child he was. Channel 4's Francesca Amaker is joining us live from a newly created memorial in Bayard where the remains were found. Francesca, what have you been told about how Chris Barton is doing?
Well, believe it or not, Mary, he found out about this discovery the same time that you and I found out on television. In fact, she was watching Channel 4 when he did find out that his son could have been found in this area in Bayard. Now, this is the memorial that has been placed here. I mean, we've been out here for several hours, and people who didn't even know the child have been here crying, signing posters, saying that they're sorry that they didn't search harder. We also asked the attorney if the five-year-old older sister of Lonzie knows about the discovery. He told us, yes, she does.
He's kind of beside himself. He doesn't just grieving.
Attorney Wesley Cassano has been representing the father of Lonzie Barton since August. He tells News 4 Jax he was brought on board for a dependency case involving Lonzie's five-year-old sister. Just a day after news broke about the discovery of Lonzie's remains, Cassano says he consulted with his client Chris Barton. He says Barton was shocked and almost caught off guard.
Nobody, you know, from Jacksonville, from the criminal side of the case in Jacksonville, notified him of anything that was going on.
Cassano says Barton has now been given access to counselors and therapists in jail to help him grieve. But Tuesday night, community members grieved in a different way. They placed teddy bears, balloons, and signed this poster with words of comfort. Cassano says this is a very difficult time for his client, so he's now asking the public to give the family time to cope with the loss.
He has been devastated by this news. He is grieving. His family is pulling together to get through this situation.
And again, the community is not stopping at that makeshift memorial. There will be a vigil for Lonzie on Thursday at 6 p.m. right here at Julington Baptist Church. If you're curious to know where I am, I'm just a couple of blocks away from the area where investigators were searching for the body of the child. Also, we're on Snyder Street. So again, this is Julington Baptist Church, 6 p.m. There will be a vigil that is open to the public for Lonzie Barton. For now, reporting live, Francesca Amaker, Channel 4, the local station.